Today we are talking about task environments. In the task environment, the agent is going to act. So agent, as we said, can be any software or robot or human, can be considered as an agent. So for the agent, we are considering piece. Piece and a piece means performance measure, environment, actuators, sensors. So any agent we take, for that agent we are going to find out the performance measure of the agent, we are going to find out the environment of the agent, we are going to find out the actuators and sensors as well. So let's take example. For example, we will take medical diagnosis system. So there is some medical diagnosis software or medical diagnosis robots, we can say. So the agent is going to replace the doctor, or is going to do the same duty that doctor does. So what is the performance measure of this particular agent? So first, the performance measure of this particular medical diagnosis system is, after getting the treatment, the patient should be healthy. So healthy patient is an example for the performance measure. And if the patient comes to the hospital, the cost should be less. So minimizing the cost, and the healthy patients, two are the examples of the performance measure. And the next thing is, what is the environment of the agent? What is the environment of the agent? The agent environment will be, so we know that this medical diagnosis system, robot or agent, is going to exist in the hospital. Yes or no? Going to exist in the hospital. So hospital, we will find patients, we will find the staff in the hospital. So the environment consists of hospital, patients, staff. And next thing is actuators. So what is this actuators and what is this sensors? We know that sensor is used to perceive the environment. So here the keyboard can be used to perceive the environment. We can perceive the environment by using the keyboard. And where this keyboard is, what for what purpose we use this keyboard, is nothing but this keyboard is used for the entry of symptoms. The patient should enter the symptoms and some findings, whatever he has, and he should give the answers. Whatever the answers the patients will give, that can be read by the sensors. And next thing is agent actuators. The actuator's job is to display the questions and give the tests, diagnose, treatments, referrals. So all these things can be considered as a actuators. So in this medical diagnosis system, these are the piece, nothing but performance measure, environment, actuators, sensors. And next, part picking robot. So this part picking robot is going to work in the industry environment, or some environment where certain goods can be transported. So what is the environment? The conveyor belt with parts and bins. This is the environment of the part picking robot. So what is the performance measure? The performance measure of the performance measure is nothing but percentage of parts in the correct bins. So how many parts are there in the correct bins? And the job of this particular part picking robot is actually to find out the, to put the parts in the correct bins. So how many parts are there existing in the correct bins? What is the percentage? Based on that, we are going to measure the performance. Actuators. This particular robot is going to have jointed arm and hand, and it is sensors can be a camera, joint angle sensor. This comes under the piece for the part working robot. And there are different types of environment, like, you know, fully observable environment and partially observable environment, deterministic environment, non-deterministic, or stochastic environment, episodic or sequential, or static or dynamic, semi-dynamic, discrete or continuous, single agent, multi-agent. So these are the various types of environment the agent can act in, these kinds of environment. What is fully observable? In the fully observable environment, the agent sensors can give it access. So we will also, as a human beings, we also exposed to the same kind of environments, like human agent. We can also take the example of human agent, rather simply saying human example, because human agent is also the part of the agents. So in the human agent case, if you take it, the human agent, for example, if there is some environment where you can see everything, that is called as fully observable. You can see something and you can't see something, that is called as partially observable. So here in this context, technically, with technical terms, how we can define is, agent sensors can give it access to complete state of the environment at each and every point of time, then it is called as fully observable environment. And if the agent sensors is not able to give the complete access to the complete state of the environment, then it is called as partially observable. So next, deterministic and stochastic. What is deterministic? Whatever the action the agent is taking right now is going to decide the next action, then it is called as deterministic. So stochastic means the whatever the action the agent is taking now, the current state and action is not going to determine the next state or next action, then it is called as the stochastic, non-deterministic. So whatever the action the agent is taking, that is called as that will decide the, if it is decides the next action, it is called as deterministic. If it is not decide, not able to decide, stochastic. Episodic means whatever the one episode will not influence the other episodes. So if one episode will influence the other episode, it is called as sequential. Static, the static environment is not changing. When the environment is unchanged, while the agent is deliberating, the environment is unchanged. And if the agent is taking an action, the environment is changing, then it is called as dynamic environment. And there is also something called as semi-dynamic environment. So we also have the discrete and continuous. Discrete means only few set of percepts are there. We can guess what are the percepts will be there, what are the actions we can take, that will not change. Whereas continuous means as we go further, we are going to find out the new actions, we are going to find out the new percepts, then it is called as the discrete versus continuous environment type. And next thing, single agent and multi agent. We know that single agent means having only one agent. For example, what is the example for single agent environment is crossword puzzle. And multi agent is where there is involvement of more than one agent. Example, chess game and chess taxi driver agent. These are called as a multi agent. So for every agent, like crossword puzzle, chess with clock, poker, backgammon, taxi driving, medical diagnosis, image analysis, so part picking robot, refinery controller, interactive English tutor, we are going to find out the various environments. What is the environment of the crossword puzzle? What observable environment, fully observable or partially observable? And what is the environment of the crossword puzzle is deterministic or stochastic or episodic or sequential. So, and we are going to find out the crossword puzzle is going to be fully observable environment, and crossword puzzle is going to be in deterministic environment, and it is sequential, it is static, discrete and single. And we can find that this chess with clock is fully observable, strategic, sequential, semi-dynamic, discrete and multi-agent. So these are the various for every agent, what is the task environment of the agent. In so if the environment is partially observable, then definitely it will lead to non-deterministic. If you are not able to see everything in the environment, then automatically it will become non-deterministic. So we can see poker, partial, stochastic. So this fully observable, deterministic, episodic, static, discrete. This is nothing but the best environment for the agent to operate. It is an easy environment where the agent can function very easily. Whereas partial, stochastic, sequential, static, discrete, partial, stochastic, sequential, dynamic, multi-agent, continuous environment, this is the very toughest environment for the robot to operate. So there are different types of the robots. Robot agents types we can categorize: symbol reflex agent, model based reflex agent.